Good morning, Sean. We've already been dealing with some of those conditions. As we take a look up the beach, you may be able to see the surf breaking on the seawall here at Hampton Beach. And right on its heels, though, Earl could start making its presence known. So people are here on the seacoast are getting ready.
If Hurricane Earl makes a run at New Hampshire seacoast, these boats are likely to head to safer harbor.
If it comes in very close, they have plans for the large boats to go to Portsmouth and some of the commercial dock areas.
Captain Peter Reynolds of the 65-foot whale watcher Granite State will stay until Friday morning. That's when he'll make the call to ride it out or head for shelter.
So it's just a matter of deciding when and if we're going to do that, really.
At Hampton Beach, lifeguards are already on edge because of big crowds, hot temperatures, and heavy surf.
Plus, we've got rips all over the place.
Rip currents closed significant portions of the beach and kept police patrolling the sand long after the lifeguards were finished for the day because so many people were tempted to swim.
With the unusual heat wave we've had in very warm water, we're at 68 degree water, it makes for a real tough situation. It doesn't look like it's going to get any better with Earl on coming up the East Coast this weekend.
For surfers, though, they see Earl in a different light.
It could mean really great waves and lots of fun.
Paul Backhouse says if the conditions are right, the hurricane could bring what's known as overhead swells, 6 to 8 feet.
The waves will start probably when it starts coming up the coast, and we'll get the swell from that, and then as it passes by, and we'll get waves maybe a day or two after that.
Later today, the State Port Authority is going to hold a preliminary discussion on Hurricane Earl. Of course, nobody knows how things are going to unfold, but they want to be prepared just in case. Reporting live at Hampton Beach, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.